Hey y'all, it is 3 o'clock on Thursday. It's the end of July. These months are just like flying by. Weeks are flying by, months are flying by, but it seems like we're standing still. I don't know what it is, but it's a weird feeling. Anyway, welcome to Rosetree Blue Studio. I am Mark, I'm the owner here, along with my wife Brenda. And you tuned in to see our Facebook Live broadcast for today. Darcy, we have nothing to show.
Oh, anyway, we don't.
Anyway, Darcy's behind the camera. We made a peacock vase for a friend, gave as a present on Tuesday, and it actually was shipped out yesterday, so we don't have anything to show you. But we don't have any finished pieces to show you. We'll show you how we make something today. Today's piece, you didn't get my clue on my post. I'm gonna do a hummingbird feeder. I was at a friend's house, or outside a friend's house, not inside, can't do that. Outside a friend's house, and in her garden, I saw hummingbirds, and it's like I haven't seen hummingbirds in a long time. So we'll do a hummingbird feeder today. I haven't done one in a long time, so we'll go through this together.
It's an adventure.
An adventure in glassblowing. Discover the magic. Okay, so it is going to be it looks like rainbow, but it's not rainbow. It's actually primary colors, just reds, blues, and yellows. There's a friend of mine out in San Diego wanted a primary color hummingbird feeder. So that's what we're going to do today. So Vaughn, if you're watching, this is yours. So we'll see how it goes. And as always, if you're watching, we love thumbs up, hearts. If you're not a follower yet, please click on the follower. We have a nice number. I'm really pleased. We just got 5,200 followers on our page, which I think is really great. And so what we're going to do is get started. If you're new, let us know you're new and say hello. And we love to have new people. And if you have any questions, write them out, and Darcy will relay them to me, and I'll try to answer the best of my ability. So, hydrate always. Let's go get some glass. So there's a blowpipe. This is what we use to get the glass on, the glass out. Those of you who've been with me a long time, I do repeat a lot of steps because we always have new people coming in. So just bear with me. There'll be a test at the end of the year. So inside here is a crucible. A crucible is a ceramic bowl. You can hold up to 400 pounds of molten glass inside. Right now it is about half full, so it's 250 pounds in here, and we're going to use a pipe to get it out. Each layer that we get out is called a gather. We're gathering the glass on the end of the pipe. So that is my first gather of glass. As you see, the glass, because of the color, is really hot. If I stop turning, it'll drip. So it is a liquid. So let's go back to my area. And this table I'm rolling on is called a barber. It's made out of steel. Not a stainless steel, it's actually a shipbuilding grade steel from the shipyards in Avondale, Louisiana. I'm going to say where we're from. We're in beautiful downtown Algiers Point, New Orleans, Louisiana. Anyway, I'm going to blow it to the end of this, cover it with my finger, trap the air inside. What happens is the cold air hits the hot glass and it heats up and expands. And you watch it push against the soft glass, it has nowhere else to go, and that blows out my starter bubble. You see the bubble just inside there. So this piece will have two layers. First layer is clear, second layer will be in color, and we'll do a little color manipulation on it after the color's on. first layer, just like that. So now what we have to do is we have to let this cool off, because if I go right back in, this is hot enough where the second layer will heat this up and it'll become really floppy. I need this to be the stability underneath the next layer. So we're waiting for, you see how it's kind of reddish orange up here? Letting that color kind of dissipate, and then that'll give us enough time to go in and get the next layer on top. So I hope everybody's had a good week. Been it was rainy in the beginning part of the week, but we did get the tropical action that they thought we would get. Today is a nice, normal, hot, muggy New Orleans day. About 94 degrees and 300% humidity. All right, so see, it's pretty much lost the color. I'm gonna get another gather on top, roll it through the color, and heat the color in.
So Cherie says it's always cool to see that bubble happen. Peterson said, are your thrown rails slightly curved to help keep pipe from either getting too close to you or getting away?
Are my, I'm sorry, thrown what?
Thrown rails.
Thrown rails. I'm sorry, I don't understand the question.
I'm guessing maybe these.
And what is it?
Are they slightly curved to help keep the pipe from either getting too close to you or getting away?
No, they're straight. I want the piece to roll. I want the piece to roll evenly. I do have a little end on it, so that if it gets away from me, it will stop.
And let me know if I was right about that, Carol. I could be wrong about what she meant there.
So I'm doing a technique called feathering, same technique we did on Tuesday. So it's four pulls back. Four pulls up, and it's the same, it's like paper decorating. It's the same kind of thing. It's a lot hotter. So I have about anywhere between 15 to 30 seconds really to do what I need to do and then have to go back in and repeat again.
Oh, she said what it's on now, so I'm guessing.
Oh, this?
Yeah.
The yoke. So the yoke is just, it has two ball bearings here that it rests on. So that way I can just pull it out real quickly on the yoke. That I did four down and four back, and now I am just keeping where the ends are right in the middle, and then I put that off, and then I'm going to smooth the whole thing out so we have some really nice up and down pulls in it. So this is on rails, which is, they're straight also. Always turning, always the turning one direction and turning the other. That pretty much keeps it centered. If I turn always one in one direction, it'll start to twist, which you can use that to your advantage. Start shaping from the pipe up. So I do the pipe first and then work my way towards the end of the pipe. Because the pipe is going to be colder first. And then I am going to heat it up one more time and start my bubble again.
Corey wants to know, do you have to lubricate the bearings on the yoke?
No. You should, but I've never had to. I mean, in theory, yes, because they're getting hot. Okay, Okay, so I want a nice high shoulder on it, and then a little bit of glass at the bottom. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat up just the bottom, swing it out, and start making the end for the hummingbirds to feed off.
When they're used 5 to 6 days a week, it's not so bad. You're not going to have to punny it?
No, I could transfer it.
Corey said for his, he has to almost every other day. They get all stuck.
Really?
And his is used every day, but it's way dry where he's at.
Interesting.
Rachel said, beautiful, and it's not even done yet. Great craftsmanship.
Try it.
Corey is shocked, I must say, that you didn't get it perfect the first time.
I did that for you, Corey. See, what happens is when I'm crimping, that's also closing that hold up. And Corey, I haven't done a hummingbird feeder ever, also. Aha! Got a hole. So again, I'm going to keep the whole piece up. If I just keep the tip up, then the back of the piece is going to get cold. If I crack it off, it'll crack the whole piece. So I'm concentrating on where the opening is, and then flatten the whole piece. Thank you.
Corey said it's so interesting to see people do the same, do things so differently. He loves the demos.
Well, I'm glad I could be of assistance. So I size it with this, so it's a little big still.
Doesn't melt that rubber any to put on the hot glass? No.
It does. You just point, put a little on, and you don't hold it there. You just do it for size. That way I know it's a snug fit.
Yeah.
All right, so next step is going to be putting the hook on. So I'm going to take it off here and over, I'm going to go over the middle of the blowing room, and I'm going to knock off the little holder there and get a loop, make a little bit of glass to make the loop on.
I definitely smell it this time.
So my friend Vaughn, while making this floor, he's a potter in San Diego. He has a studio called Dot Bear. And he makes some really cool stuff. So you're out of San Diego way and see him. I recommend his work. So. Over here.
Carrie said it could smell it too.
Rush over to the other annealer.
I don't think so. If you missed him, I missed him too.
Okay, so we didn't miss anything. Anyway, I like that y'all, I'm happy y'all came to watch, and I'm very able to share this with you. As always, please, if your stores are open in your area, please buy from small businesses. These are people that need your support. The big box stores, they'll get by. Well, we have a question?
Not a question, but Corey did say, no, sir, I would never copy your work.
Appreciate that. So buy small, buy lots from small, and if you need something from us, you know where to find us. Always, rosetreegallery.com, Facebook, Rosetree Blown Glass, Instagram, Rosetree Glass Gallery, and YouTube. If you want to see all of these 40-some-odd Facebook Lives that we have, they're on YouTube, Rosetree Blown Glass Studio and Gallery. So that's it. Everybody have a great weekend. Thank y'all for coming. As always, take care of one another, love one another, and we'll see you in August.